So, in this feature, we're going to dive into a few of the Notion integrations that you can get started with. This will give you an outline of all of the exciting integrations that are currently available in Notion. Obviously, there's an API coming, so it's going to get even more exciting, but it's definitely something to check out before that comes. So, just before we dive in, guys, if you're a beginner to Notion, feel free to join the Notion Skillshare class. We're currently working on a paid course that is a bit bigger, so that's exciting. But for now, there's a beginner course to get you started. You can get 2 months free below. So the first integration is definitely the upload PDF. Now this is great if you work in a team, for example, use it for an internal wiki. You can upload a PDF and it will securely link out to your PDF. And that's great if you want to share a PDF or even, for example, you're sharing something with clients and you want them to download the PDF inside of the Notion workspace. So this is great for storing brief folders and also files as well. Now, number two, you have the Google Maps integration. Currently, it's having a few issues because the Google Maps has changed their API. But right now, you can use it as a way to create direction routes for your events, for example, or even just tag locations. Now, as I mentioned, they're working on a fix, so it's definitely something that you'll be able to use in full functionality very soon. Number three, you've got the Spotify play button. Some people use this as a way to tag some of their playlist recommendations or also their personal playlists. So that, for example, you can have your own morning page where you open up in the morning and press play and it will start playing all of your favorite tunes as you get started, all through Notion. Number four is Loom and YouTube. Now you can actually include and embed YouTube videos as well as connect to your Loom account as well. So for example, if you wanted to onboard a few team members, you can use and upload videos to Loom and actually record them from there. We've got a full video on this one. So for example, if you share that with your team in a workspace, they'll be able to get access without having to go out to a separate link. Now, number five, Google Docs, which is one of the most impressive integrations inside of Notion. You can edit documents and files relevant to the project. So once you've embedded it, you can change the size of the window and you can pretty much just start editing, whether that's a sheet or a doc, it's a great way to get started. Number six, you can embed tweets, which is perfect for journalists and of course, anyone who's looking to source any tweets. Now, if you want to share a tweet, for example, from your web clipper using your mobile version, you can do so and it's demonstrated right here. So number seven, if you're a designer, you can use Framer, Envision, and Figma. Perfect for designers to build a wiki around a prototype. So for example, if you wanted to add loads of comments for the client to check out and then add obviously the prototype in Envision, for example, you can quickly do so. And it's a great viewing option for many professionals. And finally, number eight, you've got the Typeform integration, which is perfect if you wanted to add a survey internally or even a sign-up page for people. And even for new employees onboarding, maybe they want to get access to a new laptop and get it sent to them. You can pretty much automate that process and make it available through a Typeform document. So guys, those are the current integrations inside of Notion. They'll obviously be adding more. So guys, for now, feel free to check out the beginner's class and do like this video if you enjoyed it. Share it with a friend if you found it valuable and subscribe to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Anyway, guys, I will see you guys super duper soon. Cheers.